Okay, I wanted to tell you about the number 2084. It arises at the end of a little story. This particular one came about on a chessboard. But this is a really big chessboard. This is an infinite board. And so I'm going to number the squares. So I'll start off, I'll pick any square and number it one. And now we work in a spiral around it, and we number them. It's called a square spiral. And we row around and around and around until we've filled up the whole board. Now, what we do is we take a knight, an ordinary chess knight, and we start him off at square number one. And now we look at all the squares that he can jump to. The knight could move from 1 to 12, or from 1 to 18. The rule is we always go to the smallest square, and we can't repeat a square. We have to always go to a new square. So from 1, it looks to me like we could get to 10. There are 8 squares, and 10 is the smallest. So we're going to get a sequence, which is the sequence of the squares, where the knight goes to. So it starts off at 1. Its first move is to the smallest number that it can go to, that it hasn't already been to. So it can go to 10. From 10, it can move back to 3. So 10 goes to 3. So the third term in the sequence is 3. Then from 3, we could go to 6. 6 is obviously the next number. And then 9, 4. So that's the sequence. We do that forever? It would be nice if we could do it forever, but something strange happens. After we've been going on for a long time, it gets trapped. In fact, after 2016 steps, it gets stuck. It cannot move. Every square, every one of the 8 squares around it that it could move to, it's already been to. So the sequence dies at that point, after 2016 steps, and the last number that it reaches is 2084. And I have in my notebook here a picture of the spiral. So you can see it starts off here, and the colors, it gets lighter and lighter. It starts off fairly dark, and then we have blue and green and yellow. It moves around. There are very strange long lines of points where it moves in a straight line this night, moving 2 and 1, 2 and 1, and so on. But eventually, it gets to this red dot, and there it gets stuck. All of the 8 squares it could possibly move to, it's already visited.
It's deliciously arbitrary, isn't it? And unexpected that it could... you would have thought some pattern or system had emerged where, it's going to go forever now.
Yeah.
Does that surprise you?
It's wonderful.
You?
Yeah, that surprises me. I think it's wonderful. It's a strange sequence. The missing numbers, that's another sequence. So if we look at the ones it doesn't visit, there are infinitely many. That's an infinite sequence. And the smallest one it doesn't get to is 961. You can do it with other chess pieces. You can do it with a castle, a rook. You could do it on a chessboard of a different shape. You could do it on the kind of chessboard that you get if you just one quadrant, one quarter of the infinite board. So let's pretend we have our chessboard and we number the squares, just as we did in the spiral. Here we're going to number them in along diagonals, more precisely along anti-diagonals. 2, 3, and so on.
And then what, same game again?
You play the same game. 1. And what's the smallest square it can move to? Well, it can only move to 8 or 9, so it has to go to the smaller of them. So the sequence goes 1, 8. And now from 8, we could move to some big numbers here, but the smallest number is obviously 6. So 1, 8, 6, and then to 2, and then to 12, it looks like, and so on. So 1, 8, 6, 2, 12. Again, the sequence is finite. At step 2,402, it reaches 1, 3, 7, 8, and there are no squares it can move to. It dies at that point. Again, it's color-coded. It starts off in the corner, and as the trajectory moves along, the colors get lighter and lighter, and you see that red X there? That's where it gets trapped.
You love it, don't you?
I do. Yeah. So you can do the same thing with a rook. With a queen, it doesn't get stuck. Keeps going.
Do you play chess?
No, not anymore. I retired. I retired at the age of 14. It was taking up too much time.
So you do this instead?
Well, I didn't start this till I was in grad school.
Hey, everyone. Have a look at this. And this. And how about this? These are just some of the quizzes and puzzles and questions you'll find on Brilliant, which is a sponsor of today's episode. Now, I've met some of the people that work at Brilliant. They're real science math people, and they take it really seriously. These courses, these quizzes, these questions they're designing, they're really well thought out. They really think about how to design these in such a way that people like you, who are doing them, are going to be smarter. They really want to change the way you think. Now, there's lots of stuff on the Brilliant site that's free, but Numberphile viewers can also get a 20% discount on a premium membership, which has got even more good stuff, by going to brilliant.org/numberphile. And our thanks to Brilliant for supporting this episode. Why don't you go and check them out? There's also a link down in the description.